Yeah, hello. I will shift in English because to make it faster. So I ask for your understanding. My name is Bahaaeldin Mohamed. I'm working in Dresden University of Technology, and I have been asked to just present for you my result for project in my project e-science. Actually, regardless for from the title, this is complex title. This is the result of which tool are used for scientists in everyday life. And as well, how they are using it, and which task matching for this kind of media. Actually, before I come here, this clips actually give you my conclusion that still scientists, and especially PhD students in Germany, not in all Germany, but in at least in Dresden University of Technology, using old generation of media. As you see here, they're still using Microsoft Word 97. And I'm going to describe what does it mean, actually. Actually, I would like to present firstly the idea behind my research. We analyzed some kind of literature review to arrive to what kind of factors or how many factors we actually enhance collaboration, online collaboration for PhD students, enhance students to collaborate to each other, to get connected together, and so on. And we reach to dial relationship between some kind of factors. For example, tasks, time, activities, beliefs, support, content, incentives, and as well ethics, trust, and so on, and the communication and the collaboration. The aim of the study actually investigation of use of Web 2.0 for PhD students in terms of collaboration, and as well we would like to define exactly the factors behind the collaboration and to make some kind of relation and between these kind of factors. About the method, we used actually mixed method. Online survey has been done, and as well experiment with give students some task to do and record for them screen. We took screen recording how they are dealing with the task and what kind of technology are used. Online survey has been done during Unibark. This is online management software. Has been done in July 2012 till actually it takes 3 months for collecting data. A lot of dropouts has been done. Luckily, we have 140 already completed the survey. The second investigation, it's about to give, as I said, students some kind of task and they record the screen, how they deal digitally with this task. For example, writing, abstract, or reading a paper, and to follow up what they are doing. In terms to find out exactly what kind of technology are used, and as well, individual profile of using such media. So let us go through these kind of tasks. Everyday academic research task. Probably it's might interesting for you to know exactly what kind of daily tasks students do. PhDs do research through informally conversation every day. Search about references every week, write in every month, and publish in every year. This is exactly profile of PhD students, what we are collected. Attitudes towards using Web 2.0. PhD are very careful to use Web 2.0 for achieving academic purposes. We will see exactly why has been done. About timing. Web 2.0 in terms of saving time for achieving such particular academic tasks. PhD generally aware about the efficiency of Web 2.0 for achieving academic purpose, but not for a particular task. In general, they like it. But when you ask them, do you use it in such a particular task, like writing abstract, like collaborating with writing, like co-author in a paper or something like this, he would say no. Let us go through activities. What kind of daily activities they are deal in everyday life? I wrote up the conclusion regardless for this kind of information, I wrote for you up just conclusion of my investigation. For example, PhD are producing traditionally formally paper presentation for an authentic conference and journal. However, they are rarely creating documenting informally for a weblog and wiki. This is rarely done, actually. They go formally, but they don't go informally to present to marketing their research through weblog and something like this. No, they don't follow such cases. Attitude towards Web 2.0. PhD are more likely to use Web 2.0 academically for sharing slight information in their free time. However, they are very careful for being engaged in any online discussion, uncertainly. This might be interesting to know exactly the belief of students. PhD students right now believe that is the most important tools for achieving PhD daily task is desktop software. If you ask them why you don't go, for example, to Web 2.0, they would say, no, desktop, it's for me enough for doing research. I mean with desktop, like Microsoft Word, like such operating system and so on. Some of them in mathematical issues, they said exactly, we would like to work in black box. We don't like to share anything. I feel safe when I'm working individually by myself and doing my work individually. And what was very interesting for us, that learning management system passed away. Little of PhD students using learning management system right now, probably because they are looking forward informal information, informal sharing, informal collaboration, and so on. So learning management system, it has such a sense formally. So it's not that case. Attitudes towards this belief. Web 2.0 services are not for everyday academic practices. They said like this. Web 2.0 can enhance academic communication. Without Web 2.0, PhDs can, however, finish efficiently their research. So we are talking about efficiency. Huh? It's not kind of luxurious life we would like to have for using such media, but what make my research done easier and faster and efficiently. Through support, what kind of academic support PhDs actually need? Concerning literature review, we have three levels of PhD students. Fresh PhD students, those who start their own project, and sophomore students who they take part in the middle, and those who are senior PhD students. For example, fresh PhD students said, we need training courses and the guidance for doing research. Those who in the middle way of doing their project, we need to be engaged in a community and they need some equipment. And senior PhD students said, we need to know more about funds and jobs. This is actually logic for senior students. About technology, which tools here? Which tools for which tasks, actually? What was for us really interesting that the red color is desktop software. And the other is such kind of Web 2.0 media. So we are going to know exactly that PhD students right now prefer desktop software, closed environment, let us say, black box to work inside it. Huh? They don't like to share, they don't like, or they don't have time to make it informally. In case they have to use, or they would ask to use some kind of Web 2 services, we find here some kind of, if I have to use Web 2.0, I would use scientific databases, as colleagues said before, social media for informal communication and resource sharing, and probably use a virtual research environment in terms of data collection. It's not terms of sharing, but they collect data from this kind of environment. Attitudes towards it. They said, cool, I like to use Web 2.0 in academic in context, but context is lost. I like to use it, but in which context, in which tasks, in which level, it's not clear for PhD student. Um, What kind of language they use for writing their dissertation? Actually, we find here out that the writing dissertation mostly done by in German language, and the little bit it's 3.6 they doing in other language and international levels. Attitude of discipline toward using Web 2.0. They said there is no institutional support for using Web 2.0 in research. Email is enough, as colleagues said, email is enough for us for doing such communication and collaboration. Collaborative reading and writing via Web 2.0 is not popular in my group. They said like this. This is international PhD students, it's a little here, and this is those who are working as well in project. It's mostly done. Male accept this competition for using such media than female. And here, probably interesting, that people working in scientific fields, they don't like to get married, and as well, they don't like to have children as well. This is mostly people here using, we investigated, that mostly of them, they are not married, and as well, they don't have children. Scientific work is for us enough. motivation, actually, we surprised that the people in mathematicals and nature science already won the competition, that they are more interested in Web 2.0 than other discipline. I'm coming faster till the end. They said, finally, I prefer to use desktop software than Web 2.0 for doing my research. Trust playing a big role. They don't like to use Web 2.0 because matter of trust. They don't trust to share their own information during this. Or they are not aware about this kind of technology. With who they collaborate, actually, I prefer to work, collaborate with my small project group and the male than female. They said like this. As well, this is, result can be interesting. Internationality for collaboration, it's still growing. It's still growing for more collaboration. We make coloration, relation or correlation coefficient between these types, and we found such a relation. And this is probably a message to take home from my research here. If you would like people to use such media, you have to care about this kind of concept together, this kind of factors together. Define activities, what they have to do, support these activities, and assist their own belief of using this professional belief. And then it will lead directly to collaboration, and as well, trust. Give them trust, let them aware about this kind of tools. It will increase their own motivation, and when their own motivation already increased, probably it leads to collaboration. The conclusion is, as I said, they are still using very old media, probably related to their own competences. They are not motivated to do more. There is no support environment around them. In general, they are lacking motivation. Probably I don't have more time to do it, but if I have only 3 minutes, I prepare for you such a movie. This is screenshot recording, how they are writing. This is one student, how they deal with writing. I record just a screen for him. I asked him or them in general to search about references. And you see exactly what kind of media they are using, what kind of tasks they probably deal with directly. It's only 3 minutes. Microsoft Word, this is basically. He started to write down a structure, what he would like to do. You have seen here some kind of literature software management as well. This is probably might be interesting. Here, CTAV, they are using. Google is still dominant researching and as well some kind of particular database. If they are using different language, they use lingua just to help them somehow to formulate a statement in other language. Collecting data, reading somehow, finding, managing, rearranging, these kind of tasks that we are dealing. You see desktop as well, what kind of tools they use frequently to do such tasks as well, what kind of databases they are using, how they are searching Google still, as I said, and then some kind of specific databases. Almost.
Dr. Mohamed?
It's almost, what almost, almost.
You think we can follow you?
I can cancel now, it's okay. Yeah, thank you.
Danke. Ja, die letzten paar Slides, die werden wir bei anderer Gelegenheit vielleicht noch etwas vertiefen. Und wir haben jetzt noch